Oilers and Bruins out on the ice, and we're ready for the ceremony to honor Milt Schmidt and the anthems also tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, yesterday our Bruins family lost the man we have all come to know as the ultimate Bruin, Milton Conrad Schmidt, arrived here on Causeway Street in 1936, and in many ways, he never left. As a player, Milt was a fierce competitor who centered the famed cup line. He played in 776 games, leading the Bruins to two Stanley Cups in 1939 and 1941. And after returning from service in the Royal Canadian Air Force during World War II, went on to win a Hart Trophy in 1951. Milt would later become head coach and then general manager, setting the stage for the next two Bruins Cup victories in 1970 and 1972 as an executive. He was elected to the Hockey Hall of Fame in 1961. Milt Schmidt embodied everything we know about being a Boston Bruin, and no one was prouder to represent the organization as he had for more than 80 years. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we ask that you join us in a moment of celebration and applause as we honor the memory of a great man, the ultimate Bruin, Milt Schmidt.
He's tough. You didn't want to fool Milty, but he's a very caring person, a gentleman at all times.
Fairy tales can come true, it can happen to you. If you're young at heart, for it's hard you will find to be narrow of mind. If you're young at heart.
He was one of the great players in the history of this league, Milt Schmidt. From the beginning when he was a rookie until he retired in the 50s, he was a sensational player, respected throughout the National Hockey League and to a degree feared.
As a general manager, as a coach, as a friend, he was you couldn't ask for more. He was a gentleman.
At all times, loved this game. Had a great passion for the game for so many years as player, GM, coach. All those years he was around the game, he really cared.
To be young at heart. And if you should survive to 105, look at all you'll derive out of being alive.
Just a great gentleman, somebody you could go to, really basically, and talk things out with on an even keel, and tremendous person to give advice.
And treated us not like kids, like men. He called everybody men, man, men. You never hear him say anything wrong about us.
You know, we all respected him. He would stand up, protect his players, you know, and sometimes you help a guy out if he's in trouble. You respect the guy like that.
Out of being alive, and here is the best part. You've had a head start. If you are among the very young, as
in the National Hockey League, but I can't ever remember any regret.
Remove your caps for the singing of the national anthems performed this evening by Renee Rancourt.